So just a little setup video to help you understand the basics of your new telescope. This is a Celestron Travel Scope, 70 millimeters by, I think it's got a 400 millimeter focal length. Yep, there it is. And we're gonna cover the basics. First things first, you're gonna wanna remove the dust cap to expose that lens. And you're going to want to make sure that you've got a diagonal attached and a long focal length eyepiece. In this case, a little color 25 millimeter. And as you see it here, when you're looking up at the night sky, you're going to have some difficulties getting very high. That's going to hit. So I highly recommend switching from top mount like this to side saddle mount like this. All right, and that's going to allow you to get higher above the horizon. Okay. Just a little note, the glass in the front, you want to be really careful. Try to avoid cleaning it, avoid touching it. Likewise, the mirror inside the diagonal. Right, that's going to be sensitive to little fingers and greasy and dusts and all that type of thing. So avoid touching that at all costs. And the same goes for the eyepieces. You don't want to touch that or inside there. That's a bad idea. Each of these eyepieces has its own little function. 40 millimeter means that it's the lowest magnification. So you're going to want to use that for things that are in a wide field of view. Then 25, 17 and a half, and 6 millimeter. This is going to be for like looking at the planets, double stars, when you get to that eventually, things that require a lot of magnification, but they're going to be very dim. So small, bright objects. This is good for things that are not so bright, like the Orion Nebula and the Pleiades cluster, things like that. This one and this one will probably be the ones you use the most, but when you're trying to find something, you probably want to start with this guy here so that you can get it within your field of view to start. Got to remove the caps off of this. All right. You want to tighten this little screw, otherwise there's a good chance that it'll slide out when you don't want it to. And then have a look inside there. Let's see. And you need to move this focuser back and forth. See how that moves back and forth to achieve focus. Oh, look at that coming into view. All right, once you've got that, you can either observe what you're going to observe or switch to an eyepiece with higher magnification. All right, let's try their highest magnification, see what we get. There we go, that's with a 6 millimeter eyepiece, and that's a lot of magnification. Once you get up to that magnification, things get kind of jiggly and hard to see, and they move real fast, and well, there's really some limited circumstances under which you'd want this much magnification in a telescope like this. So when you're done, you want to kind of gently put your focuser back in all the way. Don't do it too hard at the end or you'll strip out those little teeth. That'll be a problem. Go ahead and put that dust cap back on. And put these caps back on the end of these tubes. It'll keep dust out. Put them in little baggies if that's what you got. But do what you can to protect them from the elements. And this should last for many years of viewing pleasure.